I know, you know, you tried to develop him into a heavyweight. Now, kind of, he's your guy. How have you seen him even just improve from the beginning of practice to now?
I think he's done a nice job, and just, you know, what people don't realize, it's just as hard maintaining your weight. You know, it's a challenge. You know, eating 4 and 5 meals a day and snacks in between. I mean, you know, those guys miss lunch or fall asleep for lunch and show up for practice. I mean, they're liable to have a weight change of 15 pounds. You know, it's pretty amazing. So, but he's done a good job of keeping his weight up. You know.
Also, I know you said that that locker rooms, you said it would be done by mid-December. How's it coming along?
It's not going to be done in mid-December.
Okay.
But it's getting close.
Okay.
Yeah, now it's, you can see that it's going to be here quickly.
Okay.
Yeah, most of the I think the hard stuff is behind us, and now it's just a matter of getting everything we need in.
Thank you.
John, as far as formulative stages in building your team, the end of final exams and this period between now and the start of the next semester always seems to be a crucial time, a real developing time for your teams.
Well, it needs to be, right? I mean, first priority is making sure we take care of ourselves and our grades. And then as we prepare for Bedlam, you know, you need to get better. You know, you started in November. Normally on a normal year, you've started in early November, and here you are in the middle of December. I mean, you have to get better, you know, in 6 weeks. And if you don't, you're in trouble. Because, and for us, I think we have gotten better. You know, there were some concerns early on about a few of them, but I think while we were testing on the road, both at Stanford and Minnesota, I thought we really grew as we wrestled our last bout here against Drexel. So needs to be a need to see a better team even this Sunday, you know. So,
where have you seen improvement from the start of the year to now?
Well, I think conditioning one, conditioning level, and just a matter of just the intensity level on the mat. Just, you know, it just seemed a little bit slow and sluggish and a little bit uncertain. You know, and I just felt I felt like I've seen some guys show some initiative in their offense, and we're going to need to continue to develop our offense.
What do you think of Oklahoma?
Good team. You know, look at the team. You know, they've got a bunch of guys that, you know, if some of them break through, they're going to be very competitive in a tournament setting. You know, it's basically the same team they had last year, you know, probably better at a couple of the weights. You know, I think it's a competitive team. I think with last year we won 24-10, I believe, there with some tight matches. So I think, you know, it could end up being a dogfight, you know, for some of these matches. Hard wins. I think there are going to be some hard wins, not just one way, but maybe 3 or 4 of them, maybe 5, 6. So we need to make sure we're ready, and I think OU, knowing that they're not ranked real high, but I think they're probably the most competitive team we'll wrestle up to this point. That's including Minnesota.
Coach, I know the duel's back in Lloyd Noble Center this time around, and I know that's on ESPNU. What does all that kind of say about the marketability of this duel?
Well, that's where it should be, you know, and I think Lloyd Noble is where it should be, and I'm glad that they moved it for us. You know, it is a big duel. I mean, wherever it's at. Right, it's Bedlam, and hopefully we get to wrestle a lot more of these in the future, you know, and continue with it. That's our hope. But for this weekend, we're glad we're getting to wrestle in Bedlam and Lloyd Noble, and of course, you know, last year with 25%, you know. It's a big arena with not a lot of people in it, you know, last year, but I think that'll change this year.
Are there any matchups in particular you're looking forward to?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, there's some tough matches that I know we're going to get to see. But, you know, 197-pound, you know, I think they're 97-pounders as good as anyone. I was impressed with him last year. I haven't seen him wrestle this year yet. I'll probably see a few films before the match, but really impressive, you know. So I think that's the key match, you know. Is there going to be other tough ones? Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think we have several guys on both teams right now where we have some rankings that is going to change, you know, meaning that we're not 15. We need to be top six, you know. We can be that good. I think they have some of those as well. So the duels looks to be competitive. I just don't see a lot of any matches that are really lopsided.
Well, you've been asked a couple of times about the future of the Bedlam kind of rivalry, the history about it. What has Bedlam wrestling done for the sport of college wrestling?
Well, you know, it was the first real rivalry, I think, in wrestling, you know, dating back to 1920, you know, I think it was 20, was it, Reed? Yeah, you know, and so, you know, as it gathered steam in those 20s, I mean, it became a, you know, something that maybe became the first rivalry in college wrestling, you know, and so I don't want to take anything away from anyone, you know. Some of those schools out east, you know, started before us, but for us, it was definitely a beginning of something, and maybe all of our sports, you know. So, and it has an end, you know. Been some wild matches with Bedlam. I mean, wild, you know. I've been part of them since I was 8 or 9 years old, you know, watching them, going to Norman, coming to Gallagher Hall. It was a highlight of the year, going to two Bedlam matches every year for a long time.
David Hilly?
Oh, man, that was a crazy one.
Double DQ?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Dr. Death?
Dr. Death.
Dr. Mitch?
Yeah.
Got Dr. Death?
Yeah, some interesting.
Think about this, a boy from Texas who'd never really seen college wrestling. I knew Fritz Von Erich and that kind of wrestling. That was when I was here, and I'm like, holy, this is awesome.
Yeah.
Jeez.
There's no ropes.
Yeah. This is great.
Yeah. Never seen it without ropes, right?
I mean, I swear, I think Tommy told Hilly to bite Dr.
Yeah.
Death.
Yeah. Who knows?
What he did, Hilly was 197 or less?
Yeah, maybe.